Tattoo in Menlo, Ohio. And I just set up. We're just about set up over here. Just about set up to start tattooing. And he showed me the stencil. The stencil looks amazing. He's printing it out right now, I think, just over there. I have John here. Say hi. Yeah, so I'm really, really excited. I'm not, like, my heart's pounding a little bit. I think because it's more the live stream is giving me the nerves a little bit. But, like, this will be my 10th tattoo, so, tattoos don't really, like, give me, don't really scare me anymore. Like, I'm never really was scared of tattoos anyway. But I think just the anticipation of building up. Hi, everyone! So I'm going to be getting a big lion tattoo, as in the lion from Narnia. He just showed me the stencil. It looks amazing. And yeah, so here's where I'm going to get my tattoo. I have the tripod set up right here. I'll be putting that, setting up my phone right there. Ever so often, John will be reading comments. Another one of my friends is going to be showing up here. We're just waiting for my artist. His name's Kevin Clyde. We're waiting for Kevin to come back with the stencil. We're gonna put the stencil on my skin. It's gonna be right here. Yeah, 10 tattoos is a lot. One thing that I am really excited about this tattoo, after getting this tattoo, I'll be making a video all about my tattoos, so you'll know the meanings and everything, why I got them, when I got them, where they are on my body. So Spitfire says, so out of all the tattoos you have, what was the least painful? The least painful one? Actually, the least painful one was the Disney Heartbeat one. That one was really not painful at all, believe it or not. Oh yeah, here's my artist. This is Kevin. Say
hello.
Hi.
How's it going? Let me see your arm. Let me check the size out here.
Me. Camera. Want to hold it just for a second?
Camera!
So we're still live. You want to just put it on us? Just for a minute.
Just walk over the mirror real quick. Hold it up to you so you can see.
Really?
The mirror right here. So, roughly about this size. You know,
yes.
We can always go bigger if you want, but I figure, you know, fade the mane out up here, mm-hmm. bring it out in the back a little bit, in the front, just
yeah.
to kind of fill it out.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about that?
I love it.
Cool?
So
good size?
Cool.
Awesome. All right, well, I'm gonna make a stencil and then we'll be good to go.
Awesome.
Cool?
I'm so excited. So yeah, when Kevin comes back with the stencil, I'll have John show you guys him putting it on, and then I'll put the phone on the tripod, and then we'll start tattooing. And it'll be about 4 hours, four and a half, almost between 4 and 5 hours. So yeah, so right now, what time is it? It is 11:06. My brain's going like 4 hours from now, that'll be 3 o'clock. Yeah, okay, yeah. At 3 o'clock, so yeah, around maybe between 3 and 4 o'clock. I'm gonna show you guys some of the art over here because this is really cool. Oh, that's a TV. If you guys want to check out Kevin's art, you can go on his Instagram, which is Kevin Kalai Tattoos with an underscore in between Kalai and tattoos. Kalai is spelled C-L-Y. He is amazing. He's done most of my sister's tattoos. My sister actually went to school with him. This is the first tattoo that he's doing for me. My tattoos have been done at Black Dahlia Tattoo Gallery, which is just down the street. I've heard extremely good things about Stay True Tattoo here. I've heard nothing bad about Kevin. He is extremely talented. And this stencil, you guys, is amazing. I'm gonna look at some of the comments. Angel Montez, are you getting a tattoo today? What are you gonna be getting? Do I live on the East Coast? Yes, I do. I live in Ohio, and it is just a little after 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Street Painter asks, what is your job? I am a social media director and video producer for Signature Health, which is actually down the street just that way a little bit. I also work on YouTube videos, obviously, which is why I have a YouTube channel. My main job is a video producer and a social media director. Annalim asks, when did you get your first tattoo? I got my first tattoo, it'll be coming up 4 years ago in November. It was actually this one right here. It says Nevermore. Crazy, I got my first tattoo 4 years ago. And then my second one was Let It Go right here. My third is this rose. My fourth and fifth, it's gonna be a little hard to see, but I have Mickey and Minnie here. I have the Disney and the Heartbeat. Hi, John. Disney Heartbeat. F, and then I have Losing the Lamppost. That was the next one. Then I went after that is Ariel here. My eighth tattoo is the camera. My ninth tattoo is a bit of this key right here. And of course today my 10th tattoo is gonna be this big line right over here. It will be Aslan the Lion from Narnia, which is where Lucy and the Lamppost come from. You want a tattoo of a serial killer, don't do that. I am so excited. I hate waiting, but I know it'll just be a few more minutes for him to get the stencil all done. Yeah. Norm McConnell. Yeah, I do have the same tattoo as Dodie. Yeah, she. I posted it on Twitter and she commented on it. She loved it. My favorite Disney movie is The Little Mermaid. That's why I have Ariel tattooed on me. Where in Ohio is the tattoo shop? It is in Menor, Ohio. It's called Stay True Tattoo. It's on Menor Avenue. It's just across from, you probably can't see that, but it's Melt right there. If you guys live in Ohio, Melt, there's only three locations in the entire United States of Melt. It is the most amazing sandwich restaurant you will ever go to, and it's only in Ohio. There's one in Cleveland, I believe one in Columbus, and then one maybe in Cincinnati, I think. Okay, so if you're just joining us, I am getting my 10th tattoo. I'm getting Aslan the Lion from Narnia right over here, and it'll be about four and a half hours. What music is in the background? I don't know what this music is. What? Oh, it's the Deftones. How do I come up with my video ideas? Usually I just watch real movie trailers for ideas. Sometimes I get ideas from friends, other times they just come to me. I get my best ideas in the shower. I think everyone does that. Okay, my arm's getting tired. I'm gonna put this. Last night. Okay, so I hear Kevin, he's coming back. too. I had my arm just I had my arm like this for 3 hours, and when it was done, like I couldn't even move my fingers. My whole arm was just dead from being in that one position for so long. He likes your jacket.
Thank you.
We're not married yet. Keyword yet.
I know, time's a ticking.
I think around maybe one or two.
Your hair?
Wait, whose hair are you talking about? Chase is here.
Oh, hello.
I see Danian is here. Hi, Danian. Nice beard. Thinking about getting a tattoo where your madness. Thinking about getting a tattoo where your madness one is, how would you say the pain is compared? Okay, here's the others. The pain right here.
No, it's not like games.
It really wasn't too. I would say this part is less painful than this. Because there's more muscle right here, right at the bottom of your bicep and your whole bicep, than there is here, because this is just all skin and bone and veins. Notice me, please, awesome number one. Hi!
To the pineapple on pizza guy, pineapple should be in a fruit cup, not on a pizza.
Pineapple on pizza is really good, actually, if it's made right. Like, you can't just put raw pineapple on cheese pizza. It has to actually be seasoned and, like, put all into that. And it's actually really good. I highly recommend it.
I'm gonna put an orange on my next pizza.
No, orange won't taste good.
Some grapes.
All right, you just want to make a salad. Hello, how y'all doing today? Have a very nice day. We're doing really well. Thank you for asking. I hope you're doing well, too.
Weasel cookie.
Pineapple pizza is a sin. Does your future husband have any tattoos? Not yet.
Yeah, toying with a few ideas. Probably something with David Bowie.
Mm-hmm. Oh, these are going so quickly.
Yeah, I don't know how you keep up with those.
Katie Cat K1. Danny, I'm here. I can't stay, but I just wanted to say I love you, and I hope you have a day as lovely as you. Aw, you're so sweet. Thank you. I hope your day is as lovely as you as well. What program do I use? I use Adobe Premiere Pro CC for Mac. E-Man, hi. Hi. He says hi, Mom and Dad.
You're grounded. I'm just
kidding. Aw. Hey Danny, it's Tori. You two look so cute together. Aw, thanks. Oh, like my arm is still like really sore. I was.
Why is it? You were just holding it for 2 seconds. You hold your phone all day.
I don't hold it up like this all the time.
Maybe I do.
I was holding it for like 10 minutes. Damn it, says Z-Man. How did you guys meet? We met at our local college, Lakeland. We met in a math class together.
I acted like I needed help on an assignment.
You did.
Do you have a pencil?
Someone says lots of love from Germany and hello from Russia. Hello. When did we meet? We met in 2014. Mm-hmm. I keep wanting to say 2013, but that was when I graduated.
At the time, she had one tattoo.
I did. And then, I had just this tattoo. If you go to our Instagram, John and Danny with underscores in between, you just scroll all the way down, you will see pretty much a no tattoo Danny. Math, the romantic subject. What did the buffalo say to his son when dropping him up at school? Bye, son! Oh, another good question. Who had a crush on the other first? I don't know. Who asked that? Any frick.
Well, the first time I saw her was she got dropped off by the bus and I was, drove my car there and I was walking and I noticed this kind of like cute looking girl there. And usually you just don't talk to the person, like they just go this way, you go that way. But she ended up going to the same math class that I was taking first day of school. So I picked the seat next to her. And
but which one of us liked each other first? I was in a really bad place, so I wasn't really looking for anyone to like. I think you did first because you asked me out on Valentine's Day.
I did.
So I went through a really bad heartbreak, like just a few weeks before we met. And so I went into school I didn't want to make any new friends. I wasn't looking for a relationship. I just wanted to focus on school and focus on me because I was so tired of getting hurt all the time. And then you came in.
And I don't hurt you.
No. Well, if you push my tattoo, then you'll hurt me.
I gotta watch that. And we're from Ohio, Cleveland.
Cleveland, Ohio. Right now we're in Mentor. Or as some people say, mentor. if I meet you one day, will you try to teach me to take better pictures, please? If I have time, yes. That was Raven Curata. But yeah, if I ever meet you, I would love to give you like a really quick rundown on how to take better pictures. I mean, really, it doesn't matter what camera you have. What matters is the photographer and like the angles you do, the lighting you do, the focus and everything. So you can take an incredible picture with just an iPhone. It all depends on lighting is most important. I just saw Weasel Cookie asks what.
Did we pronounce your name right? We did it earlier.
Asks what music do you like? Iman says love you both. Bye. Bye.
Peace.
What music do we like? I know you like you like some metal and hip hop.
Alternative, jazz, folk. A lot of different things.
I like pop, alternative. I like indie pop. Really, almost anything pop. I'm really into hip hop now. I just saw a comment. Do you always wear your anything everything shirt? Only when I'm live streaming.
She owns one shirt. Spent all her other money on editing. What bands do you like, Weasel?
Okay, so I'm gonna switch this around.
Let's do it first.
Try to move a little bit more. It's like right here.
So
you're not like so far behind.
What's up, Steve?
Oh, it's Steve! Get my chapstick out.
Right?
I'm about to hit 300 subs. That's awesome.
What's up, Steven?
Esteban.
How many people are joined? So we have 35 people watching
good.
Right now, and 132 likes.
That's good. Yeah, that was very technical. Got you.
I'm trying to get some big caps.
Big caps?
Taking the big caps.
You got some in the back.
No, we don't.
Yeah, big ones, huh?
No, not big ones. Bucket ones.
Just like the shot glass caps. Bathroom?
Yeah.
Oh, it's the last door on the right.
Okay.
He just walked into it.
Oh, he just walked into it.
Yeah. Fuck it.
I think he just went in there.
Yeah, the way.
If you want, I can put the stencil on for you and then
okay.
Let it dry for a couple minutes while you
awesome.
Do that.
Alright.
Go ahead and stand right here.
That was an art. I got that same guy's got a leg. I'm gonna show you.
Wait, that one guy has an arm and a leg?
Two.
Wait, he's got two arms?
Ah, he's got fucking arms. He's got fucking two arms there.
I wish I went just so I could talk like that with you guys.
We went to, me and Phil went to Massachusetts for guest spot last week.
I don't care about talking anymore.
We had some, like, there's some people from Boston, they had some crazy accents, and the whole time practicing the Boston accent is fun. Talking in it, and the whole ride home, just yelling out the windows.
Dude, I end up seeing that fucking green Kia pushing the green.
Oh, the RV?
The dump truck, yeah, I tried to fucking take a photo. It's too fucking far!
Shaving? Smooth.
Yeah,
it just helps the stencil. Yep, we're done. Line them up.
The person in the chat's like, I hear people talk about my Massachusetts family.
Depends. We are in East Hampton, which it's very like liberal. It's very. That's a nice area, you know. A lot of people. Very accepting. Very open.
Oh, that's good.
It was a good time.
When was that again?
East Hampton.
No, when? When did you go?
Oh, last. I got back Monday.
Yeah, oh, okay. Monday. Cool.
Off the map tech, dude. I'm going for that. It's rubbing off. You gotta dry off and make sure the skin's nice and clean.
Getting a lion tattoo. She'll show you the stencil in about a second.
I just didn't want to go too high with the eyes, because if you go too high, then the head starts getting distorted. So I think it's a good spot right there. Come check it out.
Do you like the placement of it?
Can you see it?
Yeah, I see it.
In the stream?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What do you guys think? I gotta go to the bathroom.
Do you like the placement of it?
I can't
really see it?
Yeah, check it out in the mirror with your arms real relaxed. You can see it natural. Way on the way.
You like it?
Cool. Alright, go ahead.
Alright, she's going to the bathroom. We're not gonna take the camera in there.
You don't need a camera in there. There's already cameras in there.
Oh, there we go. I like it, yeah. Streaming on Instagram, right? People seem to really like your art.
My art?
Yeah. I think they might have went to your Instagram or she showed some of the pictures on here.
Yeah, a lot of the, we kind of keep it more like an art studio here. So the art on the walls are mostly painted from the artists here.
Okay.
Or we bought artists from like, you know, different conventions or we're doing guest spots out of town.
Oh, cool. Are the ones up there yours?
Yeah, those are charcoal drawings I've done. I don't do a whole lot of painting. You know, it's very hard to do and I just need to do it more. But
you're painting everyone's arm essentially every day, right? A little different, but
a little different. But yeah, it's cool, man. I just gotta step it up in like different categories of art, you know, different mediums. Tattooing was the main focus, you know, and then from there I just gotta.
Are you interested in some of the other stuff? Like the
mixed
media art or whatever?
Definitely. Like painting, I love the way it looks. It's just it's very time consuming, it takes a long time to get good at it.
I bet,
so,
yeah.
Charcoal's like my thing, so I love doing a lot of black and gray too.
Okay.
It's fun getting messy. I'll get to painting eventually. When I stop procrastinating. Me and Ronnie here were talking about doing like a still life, you know, getting a model in and having her sit there and paint their, you know, profile.
Oh, cool.
So,
yeah.
A la Prima style, you know.
Yeah, that would be really neat.
Yeah, that's really hard to do, but you know, gotta start somewhere.
You know, he was talking, I thought the camera was on him, I didn't realize it was on me. I don't have any tattoos, I have a few ideas though. Probably something with David Bowie.
Hey, Danny, you wanted to do these colors, right? Like some browns and kind of like a gold, some
yes.
Like yellow, and then had that kind of like bluish gray look to it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
yeah.
Just making sure I want to get these colors set.
Can I just take a picture with mine?
Yeah, that's fine.
So,
just a few months ago, I believe April, it was just a little ring here, but it matches his key.
Okay, cool.
And then before that was my giant camera that I got September 1st of last year.
Okay, so smile on it.
Yeah. It took 3 hours and it was very painful.
Yeah?
It was just layer upon layer.
Yeah, yeah. This is probably the easiest spot of your arm to get tattooed, the upper arm. Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm hearing.
Yeah, and a lot of exposure, you know, it's like the sun, it just gets hit more than the inner.
What's funny is this one right here, this one was the actual first to be caught on Disney.
Oh, I was about to say, it looks like the Disney castle.
Mm-hmm. I don't know why that one hurt the least, because, like,
probably because it was over in no time, you know? By the time it started hurting, you recognize.
Yeah. Because I got both of these done on the same day.
Mm-hmm.
And so he did these two first, and then this one, and I'm like, this is nothing.
I was gonna say, like, I don't know, it seems like really bony in that area.
Yeah, it barely hurt at all.
How you feeling?
Meditating.
Yeah, you doing good?
Sure.
I would hold your hand, but I'm a little busy.
Huh? Now once you start touching my armpit, it'll be the restorer.
Stop counting. You know, you're just like, oh.
When was the last one you got, though?
Last one I got this, like, cobra with a dagger I got done by Ronnie. They
okay.
Were on the thigh.
Yeah. Not too long ago?
March.
February, March. Seems like a big one, though,
April.
So.
Yeah. I'm going to Arizona next month to get my arm worked on.
So. Oh, cool. Some guy you like over there, or?
Yeah, he does all my black and gray stuff.
Okay.
He's a wizard.
So after,
a wizard.
After so many tattoos, you're like, how many tattoos do you have? Yes.
Stop counting.
You should get a tattoo that says tattoo.
What is your tattoo? Tattoo. A tattoo.
Cats, man. Cats.
The song is Alice in Chains.
Alice in Chains.
The whole stream is just on you.
Well, I thought he was talking for like 5 minutes, and I thought for sure it was on him.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't realize it was staring at my beard for 10 minutes.
Like, damn, he's talking without even moving his mouth.
He's a ventriloquist.
He's throwing his voice.
The beard can speak.
They say the beard has a mind of its own.
You guys are mentioning cookies. What's your favorite cookie on the chat? I like peanut butter cookies. Peanut butter with anything is great.
What? Don't get it between him and peanut butter.
Peanut butter's great.
My boss hates peanut butter.
Oh, I hate him. I'm just kidding.
Just kidding. That was live.
Yeah, I know. He'll probably watch it.
Like, who said that? The beard?
The beard. A lot of chocolate chips. White chocolate.
I love white chocolate macadamia.
Yeah, Kitty Boss just said that.
Kitty Boss?
Yeah.
A Kitty Boss. Have you ever had someone live stream
your
tattoo? No. There's like 50 people watching right now. That's kind of cool.
It is early. It is a school day. Most people, my audience is mostly like, I don't want to offend anyone, but it's like
preteen
to like young
adults. Okay, so a little younger, yeah.
I mean, you have the demographics on YouTube. It's like, what is it, like 18 to 24 is like your biggest audience or something?
18 to 24, I believe, is like 50%. And then I think 9 to 16, is that the demographic?
Someone's like, I'm 13.
Although
at 13, she's the queen of hell, apparently. That's...
Good job.
I think they played this music there.
So yeah, if you are just joining us, I am at Stay True Tattoo. I'm getting my 10th tattoo with my artist, Kevin Cly. Kevin Cly. I always want to say Cly. I'm getting a really big lion. This is the stencil right now. I think, well, obviously, after we start the actual tattooing process, I will not be able to show you it because I can't. I will not be able to move my arm. But
I might move the camera occasionally. Yeah.
Get up close and personal.
If you guys have any questions, I could try to relay some of the questions. Can you guys hear me all right? I'm kind of behind the camera, but.
Can you guys hear me all right?
Alright, they can hear both of us.
Okay,
alright, cool.
Can you get my water?
Do you have a favorite tattoo you have right now?
Favorite tattoo?
I think my personal favorite of yours is probably the camera. But I like the rose that kind of looks like the Opeth logo.
My personal favorite is the rose as well.
I just love roses, and I love the design. I actually designed this back in, I think, 2013, and I just got it last year. So yeah, I had it in my head for about 3 years.
Would you consider getting a tattoo of Nick Cage's face on your face? They asked.
What kind of question is that? I'm not a psychopath.
Who's Nick Cage?
Nicolas Cage.
Oh, Nicolas Cage. Yeah. Oh.
The actor.
Like, what?
The guy from National Treasure?
Yeah.
But that's a good movie. Based on Con Air. Yeah, I want him from Con Air. Long hair.
The rose reminds me of the Beauty and the Beast rose, someone said. Oh, I could see that.
Yeah. I was thinking about getting a Beauty and the Beast tattoo, but I wasn't sure. This side of my arm, I think I'm thinking like just Narnia, because I'm obsessed with Narnia. And then this side, because I have Ariel, probably like a Disney style sleeve. I'm not sure really what to add to here. My cousin Heather, I don't know if Heather, if you're watching now or if you're gonna watch later, but I remember we were in talking about tattoos, and I suggested, because she loves Disney villains, I thought it would be awesome if on her left, on the left back of her arm, to get Ursula like in the same style, like no face but just shading. I think that would be so cool because we're really close. But,
I know, you need to get something now on this side, you
know?
Perfect place for Nick Cage's face right there. You have room.
Are you a big fan of Nicolas Cage?
No. I don't think you are, right?
No.
I don't think I've ever seen any of his films, so.
What? You know who he is.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
You've only seen, like, 3 films in your life.
That's true.
That clock is cool over there. It's like melting.
Oh yeah. Oh no. Yeah, it's like I don't know, Halloween or something.
It reminds me of the one that had Big Fun. How like you can put it on like the edge of a shelf and like kind of drips off.
Yeah, definitely.
Kind of like a dolly clock.
Is the name of this playlist, This Is Everything?
Oh yeah. Bang, you're doing that.
Another two?
Yeah. Reference right there.
Oh, yeah. Two that I've seen in a bar. It's gonna
be like this for the next 4 hours.
Yeah, I know. Hope you don't have to itch the left side of your face. Knees coming.
My arm was like this for 3 hours, on the arm rest.
Yeah.
And when I was done,
funny. I know you so well that I want to answer all the questions they're asking about you. Like, where did you learn to edit? Your Woodcraft colored stick arrived. Whatever the hell that is. I don't know. That's what Amazon delivered something. Oh. A Woodcraft coloring stick. Only you would order something like that. What the hell is that?
Oh, I know what it is.
Is that my sweetest day gift? Thank you.
Popsicle.
Say hi, I'm still here. And so the pain is about to begin. She's getting a lion.
Is it on me?
Not yet. It's starting. Good idea.
It's the best way to move when you're gonna tattoo. Mm-hmm. But you know, if you need to take a break, let me know. Mm-hmm. Stop whenever. When did you graduate?
I graduated in 2013 from Wheeler.
Okay. So your sister was a little bit younger than me. Mm-hmm.
She graduated.
Is it hurting?
A little bit.
A little bit? It's been a while since you got a tattoo.
Mm-hmm.
Has it been a year?
Last one I got was...
The surprise one, right?
Yeah, that was in April, I believe.
Okay. You got a surprise tattoo? What was that like?
Oh, it was this one. It was just spur of the moment. My best friend and I were getting tacos in downtown Willoughby. And she was like, I really want to get tattooed. G&G tattoo was right across the street, and so she got a little bomb tattoo just on her wrist, and I said, I'm kind of craving a new tattoo as well. So yeah, we both went in, we got walk-in tattoos, and I've been wanting that tattoo for like a few months before, and yeah, it took like not even 10 minutes, it was super quick.
I take a nap, I wake up, you have another tattoo. All right.
That's what I thought you meant by surprise tattoo. It blindfolded you.
Yeah. It's a spur of the moment tattoo.
That hasn't happened, right?
Not that I know of.
Okay, alright. It'd be hard to sign that release agreement if you can't see it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
seen those before. They're pretty cool.
They're so much fun to make.
Mm-hmm.
But my most popular series is called Blank in Seven Pajamas. It started out just as like a joke because it was at the time that the B movie was released, just like being like the major meme of the year. And so I wanted to like feed into the meme, and so I want to make a trailer for it. But there were so many styles that it could be in.
Uh-huh.
And so I'm like, why don't I just do just a bunch of different styles of trailers in one video? And so the first, it was horror first. It felt like maybe 45 seconds, and then it stopped, rewound, went to romance, stopped, rewound, drama, disaster, Disney, and it got over 3 million views.
Wow.
But then fucking DreamWorks decided to step in and be like, nope, we don't like using our content, we are blocking this video. And so yes, 3 million views down the drain, so I re-uploaded it, and
could they sue you for that?
No.
No?
No. They claim the video, but I tried disputing the claim by saying it is all done in fair use. I am not re-uploading the whole movie. I am making I'm using less than 10% of the whole entire 90 minutes of the movie. Wait, the whole video was about 7 minutes long.
Upload of the B trailer is still up there, right? Or B movie? Okay.
It has, I'd say, like maybe 25,000 views. It's really low. I mean, I don't care if it gets back up to 3 million or not, just as long as it's there. I really don't care how many views my videos get, as long as I'm happy,
yeah,
with how they are. And which is what everyone should do, like with any job, anything that they create, that they should be happy with first before they put it out to other people. Because if you're making stuff for other people and you think it sucks, you're not gonna be happy.
No. I mean, even when I post like a photo, you know, mm-hmm. I don't give a shit what kind of likes I have. My clients happy with their tattoo, mm-hmm. and you know, that's what matters.
Pro tip.
At the end of the day, you know, they have to walk around with it forever. Yeah, definitely have to check those videos out. That sounds pretty cool. I like that stuff.
I'm kind of promoting my channel, my shirt right now.
Comedian as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Comedian, actor, and extrovert. show like 8 or 9 years ago. I started watching him 7 years ago. So he was my first original favorite YouTuber.
Inspiration. Feeling good though? Not too bad?
Not too bad.
Cool.
I had a dubstep phase when I was a senior in high school.
Yeah.
Like that was like all I listened to. Like I had a wristband that it was caution tape, but it said caution, watch your dubstep.
Watch your step. That's cool. Did you make that yourself?
No, I got it at Hot Topic. Okay. I thought it was really clever. Any interesting comments or questions? Interesting, when I say interesting.
Well, iPhone or Android, guys?
I'm iPhone.
I have an Android.
Traitor.
Why are you getting the tattoo from this guy?
I have two iPads and a MacBook.
Alright.
My phone is a...
Any reason? I'm just curious.
I just always had them and I don't know. It's not that I refuse, because I'll probably eventually down the road get an iPhone.
Yeah.
I don't really need a new phone. I don't know.
I was going to say, because you have like all the other products, uh-huh. They work well together, you know.
They do.
You got to complete the puzzle.
I do. I know these guys bust my balls sometimes.
Oh, they're team iPhone too?
Uh-huh. They're like, yeah, your text come up green.
Yeah, the green bubble friends, yeah.
Whatever.
That's funny.
And when I email you and you email me back, your signature is get Outlook for Android. I'm like, no.
You said that?
Yeah. Like, traitor.
Someone's after me.
Yeah, I'm an Apple fanatic. I follow the rumor websites. I listen to Apple podcasts. I watch all the events when they announce new products. It's pretty dorky. I was very sad when Steve Jobs passed away a couple years ago.
Oh yeah. I mean, I really like eating apples. They're very good.
Me too. And speaking of apples, I'm really into baking,
mm-hmm.
and what one of the one of the pastries that I made, it was rose apple pastries with puff pastry and thinly sliced apples with honey butter in the middle. And you roll it, cut it in strips, put the apple slices down, roll it up, and it looks like a rose. It was so good.
Shit. Yeah, apple stuff is good. Mm-hmm. Like apple pie.
Yeah, it was really, you don't have any left, do you?
I do.
Is it still good?
Mm-hmm.
You have to try some. Again.
I mean, it's in the fridge, like it shouldn't go bad. Is anyone in the stream into baking?
What?
I'm talking in the stream. Is anyone in the stream into baking or cooking?
Someone says apple butter is amazing.
Anyone on the stream watch Nerdy Nummies, Rosanna Pansino? She's my biggest baking inspiration. Are you familiar with Nerdy Nummies on YouTube?
No.
Rosanna Pansino, she's the founder of Nerdy Nummies,
mm-hmm.
and she has the most popular baking show on YouTube, and I got to meet her last month.
That's cool.
She was, no pun intended, the sweetest person in the world.
Yeah. Give you some good tips.
Mm-hmm. And because I showed her a picture of my first cake pops that I made, and I said that they were inspired by her because they were really colorful.
Uh-huh.
And she was like, oh my god, I'm obsessed with that. And then she gave me her secret recipe for how to make the perfect cake pop.
Don't give it away.
Well, she already does on the show. But I got the inside of it.
She's really really nice. You know, we met her at what, Marshall's or Joann Fabrics? Or?
Joann Fabrics out in Mayfield, yeah. She's so petite. She's like 4'10".
Little thing.
She's adorable. And I've... Oh, she is so pretty too. Oh,
okay.
She's just amazing. She signed my book. I got a Polaroid picture with her. And her what she said with cake pops, in order to make them nice and firm but also taste really sweet. Because in order to make the mold of the cake, you can add cream cheese or frosting. But she likes to use ganache, which is I believe chocolate chips and warm cream. Melt that together, mix it up, and then put it into a little cake. And then mix it up, and then you mix that all up. And I haven't tried it yet, but next time I make cake pops, I'm gonna try it. Because I want to make red velvet cake pops.
That's where it's at, right there.
My boss was obsessed with my cake pops because I made some for his birthday,
uh-huh.
And I wrote October 2nd and Paul on them, and he had like 10.
Oh,
he's like, I want to die. I shouldn't be eating these.
My weakness is chocolate. If the chocolate's around, I eat it all.
Just like a chocolate bar or chocolate inside thing.
Chocolate anything.
Okay.
Chocolate anything. It depends. Like I like milk chocolate over anything. White's probably my least favorite.
Really?
yeah, it's just a little too sweet. But dark chocolate, I like when it's like kind of like peanuts in it. You know, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, dark chocolate with peanuts.
I'm a big dark chocolate fan. I'll eat dark chocolate that is like 90% cocoa. Is it cacao or cocoa?
What?
I thought it was cocoa.
Cocoa, right?
Cocoa?
Yeah.
I thought it was cacao.
Cacao?
No, like for,
cacao.
for,
some white... For
dark chocolate. Cocoa beans or cacao beans. But yeah, 90% cocoa. Where it is like extremely dark. It's really bitter. So it's an acquired taste, but it's really good.
Yeah.
Mm. It's almost like a fine wine. You just have to really appreciate it.
Well, that was down where I went out of town last week. They had this candy store, and I was like, oh shit, gotta go in there. Chocolate in the window. So I went in there, and they had just a bunch of different chocolate assortments. And the one was like a big pretzel, and it was like covered in chocolate. And they had like mini Reese's cups just like placed all over it and just drizzled chocolate so it was like infused.
Wow.
Oh man, I was like, I'll take three of those.
What's your favorite candy bar? Like or chocolate bar?
Milky Way.
Oh, I love Milky Way. I'm a big fan of Almond Joy. I really like Almond Joy.
Wait, is that the one with the coconut in it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Those aren't bad.
Milky Ways are really good. Three Musketeers are really good.
Underbrand.
Oh yeah, those are good. what kind of candy bars or chocolate bars do you guys like? This is a huge debate.
Chocolate covered espresso beans.
Oh, those are good. Chocolate covered. I had some chocolate covered pomegranates yesterday. Dark chocolate.
Someone's allergic to most chocolate, maybe.
Oh. You could try vegan chocolate. Because it might be like a dairy thing. I haven't tried vegan chocolate, but I've heard it's real good. This is a big debate on the internet, but what is your take on pineapple?
Love it. Really? Something about like a sweet and I feel like pizza sauce is already enough, kind of like that moisture sweetness that you don't need something like that. I mean, it's a preference, you know, you like
yeah, yeah. because the savory mixed with the sweet perfectly.
I really love pineapple, but separate from things like that, you know?
Some people are just so passionate about hating pineapple pizza.
I don't hate it, I just can't get into it, you know? I've tried it, definitely, I'll give anything a shot. But...
How about like barbecue sauce on pizza?
That's good. Barbecue sauce with chicken and cheese on pizza.
Oh, kind of like a buffalo, you're not buffalo, like a barbecue chicken pizza.
The pesto pizza we had was pretty good.
Pesto pizza with goat cheese.
Yeah, that was really good.
Pretty good. Yeah.
You can get that at Whole Foods. It's so good. Have you been to Blaze?
Blaze. It's a LeBron James one or something.
That's, yeah. That's how we all know
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it's like
a, I thought it was like only a local thing that he kind of just brought here, but I guess like I have a friend in Arkansas, and he was like, yeah, man, it's my favorite place. I'm like, if Arkansas has it, it must be a, you know.
I had it a couple months ago, but it was like reheated from my buddy bought it earlier that day and just put it in the oven, reheated it.
Okay.
It was good. Yeah. Like, I mean, I love pizza in general. I'll eat fucking any pizza just because a combination of like, you have like bread, cheese, and sauce together.
Yeah.
It's just amazing. It's great. Great combo.
And I like to dip it in sauce. I'm like a dipper.
Especially your crust. There's nothing on it so dry.
Yeah.
The dipping sauce.
While I'm not a huge fan of pizza, they did change the game with the stuffed crust.
Oh, yeah.
You know, kind of add a little bit more to that crust. But yeah, Blaze Pizza, it's like a Chipotle for pizza. Like
you get to kind of pick and choose what
Yeah, personal pan pizza.
That's cool.
And you have the choice of thin crust or thick crust. Highly recommend the thin crust is worth the extra $2.
Oh, yeah. I'll pay extra for a good meal.
Yeah, and you can get unlimited toppings. There's so many meats. Sauces, vegetables, and you can get extra salt on it. Highly recommend
using
sea salt
because
it brings out all the flavors.
Cleveland Pizza Company is pretty good too. You can choose a bunch of different sauces.
I haven't been to that many pizza places. I'd like to change that.
See, I like to even like cook pizza. You know, it's good. And my buddy. He loves to cook a lot. He's very good at cooking. A few years ago, you know, he got fresh dough from Alessi's and like, you know, just whatever, you know. He made like a margarita pizza, which is just like those like chunks of the provolone cheese just like set on it with that and then the balsamic vinaigrette and like what else? Cut up tomatoes, like bigger chunks. And, I forgot what kind of basil. And he just threw it on top of a grill and it hardened real quick, you know, and then flipped it and then flipped it back and then put all the stuff on it.
Oh wow.
Dude,
yeah,
amazing.
It sounds
amazing.
Really good.
Yeah.
What's going on?
And that he made it like personally for you guys, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, he loves to cook, so he came up one time and smoked a brisket for like 8 hours. Came up super early in the shop. Hung out. By the time we got here, it was like halfway through, and then we ate around lunchtime. He just loves to cook. So that's his thing.
Yeah, definitely would say that, you know, cooking can be an art form, you know. Like,
yeah. He's a barber now, though. He's awesome at it. So.
Oh, a barber?
Yeah. But he still cooks. Man. It's a good meal.
I've gotten really into cooking this past year, and my sister's gonna have a Friendsgiving the Tuesday before Thanksgiving. And I'm like, I'm bringing everything.
Yeah. Yeah, Friendsgiving is cool. A couple of my friends do it. It's nice to get it together, you know, have some drinks, eat a little bit, whatever. Have a good time. Yeah.
When we move in, I'm really gonna have a tradition of having friends come over like before or after Thanksgiving.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
Christmas and just have a bunch of like friend get togethers. And it doesn't have to be for the holidays either. It can just be like, hey, let's have a game. love the plain beans, and I love Dwarf cheese, such as Scrabble. One of my favorites.
You ever play catchphrase?
Yes, it's so funny.
What game?
Catchphrase.
Catchphrase? You like download it on your phone? You ever do that?
We actually have the physical game at home.
But like if you're at a bar or something, or hanging out with your friends, or somewhere where you don't have it, you download it on your phone, you just put it to your forehead. So if me and you were partners, I'm trying to guess and you describe it. So like if you get it right, you flip it up. If you don't, you just flip it down and pass it. But it's fun. It's wild.
basically catchphrase, you have a word, or two words, dog, cat, car, building, and so the other person has to describe it for you.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, that's cool.
And there's a timer, and a game like that is taboo, where you have a word, but then you also have a list of words that you cannot use.
You can't say the word itself, you know?
Yeah.
And there's categories too, like any movies, animals, like anything.
With taboo, like you can have the word cloud, but you can't say the word sky or sun or rain. So you have to have this term like, puffy things in the air.
Puffy white things in the air create precipitation. Trying to act smart, I don't know what I'm talking about.
Feeling over there?
Fine. It's a little painful, but I'm good. it kind of feels like Toba scratching my arm.
Really? Oh, yeah. Okay.
If Toba had razor blades for a couple of nails.
Needles for nails. What's Toba? Toba?
Toba. T-O-B-A. She's a rescue. She is a pit bull pointer mix. She's really, really cute, really smart, but she's so overprotective and she's a little aggressive. And so it sucks because we can't really have anyone over the house anymore. but she's known John for 2 years since we've had her, and she's finally accepted him. Very rarely will something be triggered by her and she'll bark at him, but like she's never bitten anyone. She'll play bite, but she's never like gone out of her way to fight anyone. She is not like people or dogs.
So rescue, was she like abused or something?
We're not sure. She was found on a road, so we're almost positive that she was like thrown out on a busy road because she's not passing cars. But she loved going in cars. she used to be really afraid of cars and going into them, because whenever she would go into the car, it would be to the vet or like to a place that just would not be fun for her. So her foster mom, whenever she went into the car, they would always go to McDonald's and she'd get like a cone. So it was like it was fun. And now whenever I have to like take her to the vet, take her to get a bath, or just like to go for a walk at a park, they're like, "Oh, you want to go Bubba's?" And she just starts running around the house like, "Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy." She's so cute. I can't bring up a picture. I don't have my phone on me.
She's small? Smaller?
She's medium size. She's about 50 pounds. She's supposed to be 40, but she gained some weight. But it's mostly muscle.
Mm-hmm.
So she's a medium-sized dog. She's so cute. Have you know the picture of her?
Yeah.
You know she is.
Oh, okay. I like the black eyes.
That's my puppy. She just turned 3 this year. Do you have any pets?
I do not.
Highly recommend if you ever get a dog, highly recommend adopting from the rescue.
Yeah, that's what I keep hearing. So I was gonna go to a breeder,
dog is not huge, so I don't want to get anything too big, too. And those dogs are so fucking cute, so. But, I don't know. It's hard, you know, being busy and, like, I don't want to, like, feel like I'm neglecting it because I'm here a lot, you know, doing a lot of work, so. I'd rather just, you know, wait. I don't know. How I'm like, slow down. I don't know. You know? Fine. I'll make time eventually.
It'll be fun if tattoo shops, like, at least one of the artists brought in their dog, like almost like a therapy dog, for people just to like, for the dog just to have his head on your lap, just to have his dog on your lap, so that way like people's anxiety goes down, and just so you have some form of entertainment besides talking to everyone.
I think there's like a violation with like the health department about like care and...
Oh, I could see that, yeah.
Or something like that, you know, open wounds and... You know, especially I don't want to sit here and worry about him, like, getting into some garbage or bloody, like, gross stuff or whatever.
Dog shitting over here, dude.
Whoops. Not you.
Okay. I was like, what?
You guys still good out there? It's we're dwindling. We're down to 17.
It's okay. It's a school day.
Skip school. I'm just kidding.
12:14. And I'm sure a lot of my tattoos on the brain, a lot of my followers either live Pacific Standard Time or like overseas, so they're like 6 hours or more ahead of us.
Yeah. Some people are saying I'm in class right now, and hi from England.
Hello, I'm from Ohio.
Phil, did you put this on?
America. That's a big phone. Really? Oh, yeah.
It is an older movie. I don't know what it is. Ronnie, you know what this movie is?
It's a
Bamba.
Kind of like an FBI, or not FBI, some agency set up to catch these bank robbers.
Oh, okay.
And it kind of takes place after it happens, like the bank robbery happens and goes bad, so now they're
Steve
all the
Buscemi.
Criminals are back in the
fucking... Steve Buscemi's the best!
Not him. Yeah. You know, thing, trying to beat the shit
out of the movie was a Japanese movie first. And
really?
And stole the entire thing and made it...
Oh yeah, I was just describing it to you, don't worry.
Yeah, it's true.
I was listening. Stay gold, pony boy.
Stay gold.
I think you've changed. If anything.
I can feel it tingling in my fingers. I gotta move them.
Put a little numb?
Yeah. You guys are just joining us. I'm getting my 10th tattoo with my artist Kevin Clyde. We are at Stay True Tattoo in Menor, Ohio. And I'm getting As I'm the Lion from Narnia. And it's been about 45 minutes, maybe? Maybe a little less. I lost track of time. Okay. It's not good to watch the clock while getting a tattoo, because then time goes slower.
Just drags.
Yeah,
favorite tattoo that you've ever done?
It's always hard to say that because every time I do a tattoo, I'm always like excited to try and like push myself to the next one. So it's hard to say one thing.
Or do you have like a favorite thing, a favorite tattoo that you do on most people?
That's hard to say too, because I try to switch it up and be as custom as possible. So that way I'm never doing anything close to what I've done before. Anything realistic, you know, I love doing it. I've done a lot of lines, you know, from what you've seen.
When my sister showed me one of your lines, she's like, you need to get your line tattoo done from Kevin. I'm like, sign me up.
Sign me up.
When it comes to realism, do you like doing animals or people?
It's hard to say. It depends on what it is. I would say it's probably like 50-50, mm-hmm. because if I can get a good reference and like photo on an animal I've never done before. I love it because it's something, it's always a challenge, you know, doing something I'm not used to. It's fun that way. But also, you know, portraits and stuff are super hard to do.
Yeah.
There's not a whole lot of room for error, so that's fun too because I like the challenge, like I said. No. I would say, depending on the animal, probably an animal. I did that at the Hell City Convention in Columbus.
Mm-hmm.
That was when my good buddy did.
Mm-hmm.
That was the first like actual gorilla I've done. I've done monkeys and stuff before, but mm-hmm. yeah, it was super fun to do.
I checked out your Instagram this morning. I saw that you did Pennywise, and I'm like, that is sick.
Oh yeah, thanks. Yeah, that was a drawing.
That's awesome. I haven't seen the movie yet.
Hey man, I'm not prepped for that.
Huh?
Want to
see It soon?
Yeah, sure. Is it still in like the? I imagine it's still in like the proper theaters.
Yeah, it'll be in probably for at least another month because it's so successful.
And with Halloween coming up, you know.
Oh yeah.
You should put a trailer, make it comedy.
I get so many comments on that, and like when the Emoji Movie came out. Everyone's like, do the Emoji Movie, do the Emoji Movie. I'm like, buy me the fucking DVD.
Oh, strong language.
I can't even count just how many comments I've gotten with people asking me to do a movie that just came out to theaters. It's like, I can't do that. I can't do that yet. Gotta wait a few months. But yeah, when the new It comes out on DVD, I'll make something out of that. Maybe like a romantic comedy.
Mm-hmm.
I recently did Scream from the 90s.
Oh, okay.
I did that as a romantic comedy.
Nice. How was that?
So I was like, no killer at all, and it was pretty much just like a high school romance.
Okay.
I really like it. I was really proud of it. I'm gonna blank. How did that one go again?
who like, do you know how like a trailer is like just commentating? Are you the one saying it?
No, I'm only in one trailer with narration, but it wasn't me. It was one of my followers.
Okay.
His name was Nicholas Salazar.
Mm-hmm.
And he has that really classic deep movie theater voice. But he's Hispanic, and so he has something, a little bit of a Spanish accent. But oh my gosh, it was perfect.
That's awesome.
And it was really cool because a few months ago I asked everyone on Twitter like, what was their favorite thing of what's your favorite thing about yourself? And so he commented back on the video. He's like, my most favorite thing about myself, I love my voice.
That's cool.
And I'm like, dude. dude, you should go into voice acting. He sounds like Antonio Banderas.
Mm-hmm. He's got a good voice.
Mm-hmm. So I hit him up on Twitter, and I sent him the little script of stuff to read off. He did an amazing job, and it was for, this is back, I think in July, I did June, I did a Christmas comedy, because so many people were asking for this one specific YouTuber, Crank Gameplay, it's in Ethan. And so I want to do a parody called Christmas with the Cranks. But people just would not wait until December, and I couldn't wait. So I'm like, oh, let's put it out in June. And so he narrated it over, and he's like, what's the name for Christmas? And Jolly Holiday. Little did these three know things are not being okay, and like I it was just a riot in it. and I sent him the original trailer for Christmas with the Cranks. I said I kind of want like the tone of it to be like this, like funny but also like kind of confusing sounding, like things would not be okay, and this Christmas things are about to get a little cranky.
Got some little corny jokes in there. It's always fun.
Yeah. With my trailers, if I don't have enough footage, because I don't create any of the footage that I use, I only download what is available to me, whether it's the full movie or a certain chunk of videos from the YouTuber.
Okay.
I like to add to it to like kind of tell a story. I like trying to refrain from because I recently watched a video on what makes a trailer really, really good. And they recommend that if you put text in there or narration, depending on what the movie is, it almost takes away from the trailer itself. So only if it's like really necessary or if I don't have enough footage to work with, will I put text in.
Okay.
But a lot of times I like to put a tagline in, like the worst is yet to come, or
something to keep people interested.
Yeah. Nothing will prepare you for what happened that day or something like that. But each video ranges from about a minute and a half to about 3 minutes, depending on the creator, how much footage I have and how much time I have to edit.
Yeah.
Because I upload every Saturday, and I normally don't have that much time to work on it throughout the week because I work full time for Signature Health. So I have about maybe 5 hours a day to work on it. And
we got another full time job.
Yeah. Each trailer, it can range from 10 to 20 hours of work. It's so worth it. It's so
much fun. Yeah, a bunch of editing and reviewing it, making sure it makes sense.
And my life is pretty much my YouTube channel. It's just, literally all I do is editing. And so editing really is the right thing.
Do you like your actual job, girl?
I do. I also get to edit. I get to shoot video of the staff that were there. Usually explaining what a certain program is, or if we're opening up a new location, which we've done a lot in the past. We've opened up a location in Painesville. We're merging with Connections is merging with us, but they have locations at Beachwood and Cleveland. And so we're gonna make more videos on that. We also do weekly vlogs where we have two employees come to my office. I have a little studio there, and they sit down and we shoot like maybe 2, 3, 4 videos one day.
Yeah.
I shoot them all in that same day. So we have 4 weeks of videos all
talking about. And I feel like
It's just an amazing company. Everyone works as a team. Everyone looks at each other equally, no matter if you're a pharmacist, if you're a counselor, even if you're just a case manager. No one's job is better than the other.
Mm-hmm. That's cool.
Mm-hmm. My boss is so cool. Like, I've known him for almost 5 years since I was an intern at Signature Health, for 2 years before that. Shout out to you, Paul. he's so funny. He's like the cool grandpa that everyone wants. He's like a father figure to me. He's one of my best friends. He's so generous. Like we went to New York back in May, and I told him we'll put all the plan, and he reaches into his wallet, and this was the day before. He reaches into his wallet, hands me a $100 bill. He's like, "Have dinner on me."
Oh, looking good. See him.
Mm-hmm. So if anyone's wondering, yes, tattoos are painful. I'm like obsessed with the smell of a tattoo shop. It just smells so good. Like it just smells clean.
Yeah.
And like obviously it's not like a baked goods kind of smell, but it's like it's
clean.
Mm-hmm. It's a relaxing smell, because I know some people think that tattoo shops are so dirty and really grungy, because I know a lot of the older generation think that, oh, on other people.
Yeah.
Like she would never get a tattoo on herself, but she loves looking at them. Like if
she appreciates.
Mm-hmm. And she loves to know the meaning behind it. Like if there's like a quote on someone's arm, she always wants to read it. Like if she's at like Giant Eagle or something, and the cashier has a really cool tattoo, like she'll say, oh, what does your tattoo say? Like what does it mean? And
yeah.
She loves hearing the backstories of them.
See, people like that are the type of people who eventually will get one. You know, because they're so interested,
mm-hmm.
and they're always like, oh, I really like him, but I don't like him on me, because it's hard to commit to something like that. You know, I've tattooed a lot of, like, you know, people throughout the years where, like, you know, the parents will come in, you know, watch the tattoo process, hang out, talk. Oh, I would never get one, but I really like them.
Mm-hmm.
A couple years down the road, I'm giving them half sleeve. You know? But it's always funny with that.
Mm-hmm. I don't think my mom is really the type of person to get a tattoo. If anything, probably like me and my siblings' birthdays on her. Like, and something really nice, like with like a rose.
Yeah.
I really want to get a tattoo on the back of my right shoulder, in watercolor, an elephant with a cardinal.
Yeah.
And like whenever I say this to people, like that's an odd choice of animals. But the elephant, they'll represent my grandparents. That they passed away a little over 10 years ago. And I would really close with them. And so the elephant represents my grandpa because he always tell elephant jokes. And the cardinal would represent my grandma because she loved bird watching and her favorite was the cardinal.
What kind of elephant jokes would you say? Remember that
day?
It's a great time. to 88, so I don't really. Mm-hmm. I wasn't like raised in the 80s, but.
Right. I do remember the new millennial from the millennials.
Like when 2000 hit?
Yeah.
Much.
How many people are watching?
We dwindled down to 13.
Okay, what time is it? It's 12:41. Maybe at 1 I'll end the stream, just not people are.
And you can put it back in on right near the end, that's fine.
So yeah, if you're just joining us, we are, if you're just joining us, I'm getting my 10th tattoo with my artist, Kevin Kly. We are at Stay True Tattoo in Menor, Ohio, and I'm getting Aslan on my left bicep. And the stream will come to an end in about 20 minutes. But when my tattoo is just about done, we'll start the stream back up. So I know a lot of people are in school. I keep thinking it's Friday. A lot of people are in school. It's still early, but I'll be posting plenty of pictures on Twitter. And when this heals mostly, I'll be making a video, probably with my best friend Melissa. You guys know Melissa. I went to the Markiplier show with her. I'll be making a video with her about what do our tattoos mean.
Oh yeah, you're gonna do that.
I feel like 10 tattoos is a good milestone. To be like, oh yeah, what are my tattoos?
How many does Melissa have right now? Four, okay.
our friend Melissa, she has, which is a brain and a heart balloon.
Uh-huh.
Little tin dots.
Yeah. Because everything else over here, like, it really was not that bad. It feels like someone's playing violin on my arm with a knife.
Oh, alright. That's a good way to sell it.
Violin with a knife.
Yes. Sawing my arm with a knife.
I've been seeing people getting these eyeball tattoos over the internet. Have you seen that at all?
Getting their eye?
Yeah.
So you just want to go?
Yeah, it's stupid. I'm not a fan of it. You know, put contacts in if you want to have different color eyes. One lady went blind.
I bet. I don't know. Didn't really look that great either, you know, just kind of...
Yeah, it looks like you haven't slept in a long time and your eyes are bloodshot or whatever.
Yeah, right.
I saw on a blog from one of David Dobrik's vlogs, they went to a tattoo shop, and one of the tattoo guys had an entire eye tattoo, like, all black. And, like, it was so gross, but so cool at the same time, but still really gross.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't want to risk my eyesight.
I mean, wouldn't that, getting poked in the eye hurts. I can't imagine having that on my eye, you know.
I think they use, some kind of, syringe needle or some shit.
Okay.
I don't know. I mean, you probably look it up and just see the process happening. I don't know.
I was going to say, you know, 99% of your body can be tattooed. Let's go to the 1% you can't.
Yeah.
Or you shouldn't.
Oh yeah, I've done some freckle dots before, Marilyn Monroe type beauty mark things.
Mm-hmm. I saw this is on Twitter. So somebody got rainbow freckles all over their face, or not all over their face, but on their cheekbones.
Yeah, the Skittles commercial.
Yeah.
Skittles box.
Kevin, what's it like tattooing
me? You?
Yeah.
I just feel bad the whole time because I'm hurting my friend.
See?
Like, oh, Ronnie, it's okay. We'll be over here soon.
What was the first tattoo that you got?
My first one I got was, I was 16, and I thought it was super cool at the time. It was a scorpion on my chest. Yeah, I thought it was really cool, but...
You still have, you didn't cover up or anything, did you?
I'm going to.
You're going to?
Yeah, I when I get my upper torso tattooed.
Okay.
I'm going to get that covered. I'll have to get a laser first and then cover it up.
What inspired you to become a tattoo artist?
When I was younger, getting tattooed, being hanging out in the shop and watching my brother get tattoos with his friends, I always thought it was a cool process. I used to draw a lot growing up. Hanging out in my room, practicing and stuff. I didn't really want to be a tattoo artist when I graduated high school. I wanted to do something with art, but I got the opportunity to start an apprenticeship and I just took it. And as soon as I started, I understood how serious it is. You gotta put 100% into it. So I was like, alright, well, I guess that's what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't want to waste time trying something and going back to the house. So I kind of like doing that. I like everything I do now, so I had to commit really hard. Being a young kid, you don't really have a full-time job or anything. In high school, you work, stocking shelves, you're doing something simple, working at a restaurant. Yeah, so as soon as I graduated, I didn't really want to do something like that, but when I got that opportunity, I was just like, all right.
Did you start right out of high school, or
did
you wait a year?
No, right out of high school.
Okay.
Like, graduated, June or something like that, and I started tattooing in August.
Oh, nice.
This past August was 10 years.
Oh, awesome. Congratulations.
That's
crazy.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. It flies by. I still feel like there's so much more to learn.
Right.
In actual leadership apprenticeship takes time, and that shop, the boss, they really just wanted to hire people and put them on the floor just in order to get them to make him money.
Yeah.
And it was really, really shitty because I didn't understand anything. were very sheltered there because he didn't want us communicating with any other artists or like anything like that, going to conventions or going to shows, because he wanted to keep us there, you know. And I kind of broke out of it and I said, screw it, I'm going to convention, you know. I'm going to convention. I saw how accepting and how open the tattoo community is and how everyone's so willing to teach each other and learn, like seminars or, you know, books. There's just so much to learn. And it opened my eyes. And I was like, wow, you know, this is it. And my goal was to build up my portfolio and get as soon as I can get out of here. So I did. And it's been going good ever since, you know. Commitment every day, you know, like every day counts, especially if you have something that's so permanent, you know, like a career like this. It's not just a career, it's a lifestyle, you know.
Yeah, when you're so passionate about something, like, it doesn't feel like work.
No, not at all. Yeah, I'm thankful every single day, every day. You know, I could be doing something else, meaning my life, but if I messing up and like, you know, working somewhere else down the road in my life, I want to like just make it count.
I'm like, damn, I am a professional editor.
Especially when you see growth, you know?
With every video I do, I always learn, something from that. I'm still learning stuff about the program. Like, I just realized that I'm able to delete one single cut instead of having to delete the whole thing and put it back in, like, cut it out. I can just click on the one cut and delete it right there.
That's cool, like little shortcuts, I guess.
Yeah.
You know, the time you put into it makes it work.
I was like, why did I not know how to show this before?
It's like that with tattoos, you know, like I said, every time I do one, I always learn something.
Oh, sure.
Say, okay, well, next time I do a tattoo like this, or whatever it is, I'm going to approach it this way. And, you know, studying, like, an artist has to like their style, studying their work, and, like, trying to find out what they do to create an image and make it that look the way it does, you know? What makes an eyeball look wet? What makes a, you know, fur look furry? What, you know, all these little tricks and stuff, and I just study it. Understand what needle tools I need to use to make that happen. Can I go from there?
With all my videos, I always try to top myself with something in the video, whether it's with music, style of editing, story. So I always try to raise the bar with every single video. Last week's video, I raised the bar way too high, and now I have a total editor's block with this video. I haven't even started it yet, and like I have a story in mind, but like I've just been so crazy busy, and like with a tattoo coming up, with an event coming up at the new year, and like all the stuff
trying to get
this weekend. I've just drawn a complete blank this whole week. I feel like I raised the bar way too high from last week, and I'm like, I'm never gonna be able to top this month.
Yeah, you will though. You will, because I get like that when I make create a drawing or when I do a tattoo or something. I'm like, oh, it's awesome. Mm-hmm. I love how it came out. And the next time, someone's like, oh, I want something similar. I'm like, okay, well, how do I do that and then top it?
Yeah.
And that's why sometimes I sit here and struggle with drawing for hours and hours and hours, like racking my brain. Like, man, I don't want to do something like similar to what I just did. I gotta like step it up, you know? And it's awesome because there's so many times you feel like a plateau, and then all of a sudden the next time you do something, you look back 6 months and you're like, man, that one video I made was sick, and I thought I couldn't top it. Now I'm like way ahead of the game, you know? It's just that constant pushing yourself, like I said, and commitment.
Yeah. This last week's video, I
Wrote
from a vlogger, his name is David Gilbert, and so for the entire month of October, I'm doing just horror trailers with just YouTubers.
Okay.
And so, part of me is thinking, like, I should have saved this one for last, because, like, I would have run out of the bang, but I did a found footage style trailer.
What?
Found footage.
So,
like paranormal activity, Blair Witch
Project. Oh, like a first person, yeah. Like shit on camera.
Because yeah. All his videos were vlog style, and so they're all first person. And I'm like, this is the most perfect perfect style for this creator. And so I went with it, and he reacted to it on his channel. He has a combined total of about 8 million subscribers. And I gained almost 10,000 subscribers just from him.
Wow.
And like his thoughts on it were like, this was amazing. And like, and hearing that from someone who I look up to is so surreal and really humbling. And I'm like, this person who I admire and I look up to and I really like, really likes what I just did.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one of the coolest feelings in the world. Because when you look up to a celebrity, and so many other people look up to a celebrity, they're like, oh, that person is amazing, they're my idol, blah, blah, blah. But then when it's you who's getting all that praise, it's like...
Yeah, I think it's surreal, like you said.
can I pinch myself? Like,
yeah.
Can, is this real? But I don't take it for granted. Like, it's very humbling. It's very very uplifting, very inspiring, and just seeing all these people from around the world who come together and watch my videos, it's so cool.
Yeah.
And they don't realize it's not negativity. Just at the beginning of the month, I went to a show from Markiplier. He's a popular YouTuber, he has almost 20 million subscribers. He went on tour, and I got to meet four people who watched my videos in person, which was so cool.
Give them good feedback.
I had to, like, it's, like, reading comments and, like, and watching reaction videos is one thing, it's all legal, but, like, when you wake up face to face with someone who admires your work, and who just appreciates you as a person, it's so much different, and it is absolutely incredible to hear that face to face, and, like, you get to hug them, talk to them, and, which is how I felt when I met Rosanna Pansino this last month. Like, I went in, like, my arm was I was shaking all over, and, like, I told her that I loved her so much. I loved her show, she's adorable, and, like, and she's just a regular person. And, like watching all these movies, celebrities, YouTubers, like, all these people of higher power, because of their popularity, because we look up to them, we put them on such a high pedestal that when we see them in person, we're like, oh my goodness,
yeah.
It's God in person.
Yeah, starstruck.
But
yeah.
They're just people.
Yeah.
And it's really cool, but also, like not really weird, but awe-inspiring that, like, these people who you see in the movies, they're just like us.
They are. They're not aliens, you know, they're born and raised just like you, and they have the same feelings and everything, it's just, they just chose a different path, you know?
They have a lot of fans.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm like that when I go to like conventions and stuff, you know, there's like art, like, first of all, I mean, it's sort of a convention, it's just like a lot of big names, you know, people are looking at magazines for years, and they get a tattoo, so I don't think that's like a huge goal, you know, and I'm like, I'm blown away that I can do that. Do it. I was like, all right, well, I gotta step it up. Well, these dudes are looking at what I'm doing. And, you know, I it's scary, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely humbling. Very inspiring. You get to do stuff like that. So you're actually, like, moving forward and progressing in what you love to do. You know, just last week when me and Phil went to just that tattoo shop, you know, it's one of the biggest names, and they have like the sickest artists around the world coming in there all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I was able to do that, and it's just huge, you know,
mm-hmm.
Very inspiring.
Mm-hmm.
Just
awesome.
Couldn't wait to get back and start tattooing again here. You know, it's just
cool. And my sister has been going to you for 5 years now?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so,
I think the last one I did, I was on her thigh or something, or like a symbol thing. Right?
not really.
I think it was on her thigh.
Oh, is that the little tribal thing?
Yeah. It's like a symbol, crosses with the lines and like.
It looks like a little man? Or that. No,
I don't know. I don't even know if you've seen it. It's been like maybe a year since I got tutored.
She has one on her thigh. I think it was a little African.
It might not have been on her thigh. I don't know. I'm trying to remember.
Whew.
I know she went to. She got something
around.
Oh, wait. I know she has a lot of pictures and words, but like I think the other symbol was all on her finger. I don't know if you did that. No. I know she has She goes, leave the tennis rackets on her back. She has white ink in slipping in friend. She has Hakuna Matata, a giant tree. Did you do the tree on her? It was all on her side.
I don't think so. No, I can't remember. Because when I do a tattoo and then I tattoo someone so much throughout the years, I'd have to see it and then say, oh yeah, I did that. You know, it's hard to remember everything I've done on someone. You know.
You think of the semicolon?
I don't know.
Cause just so many. she has infinity and love on her wrist and the semicolon on her other wrist. She has a big dream catcher. She has the little African tribal symbol. Is it African?
Leave it on.
I was going
to say, you can't leave it on longer. Just no longer.
She has.
By the time I get to work,
a puzzle piece behind her ear.
Yeah, it's usually done.
And a lotus flower on her arm.
And that's just it.
I think that's
it.
Soak
up the shit
over
there.
Well, it's the. So many have lost. I'll look down and like, oh yeah, so I have this.
Yeah.
Like, whenever I'm showing people my tattoos, I always forget the one that's on my chest right here on the collarbone, let it go. Like, because I can't really see it unless I like contort my neck to look down. But I always forget about that one, and they're like, oh, about that one. Like, which one? Oh yeah, this.
Oh yeah, that one.
And I normally wear my watch on my left hand, and so it comes up Nevermore right here. So I forget about that one too.
Many.
Okay. So, thank you guys so much for watching.